Hi. Be sure you click below to find the link to see what the caravan looked like originally. 2012 was the last year FunFinder made this model, which is actually 13.9 feet, but most often referred to as a 14 foot. The construction quality is quite high, and it was really very influential in choice. The previous owner added this queer little table underneath Square Squirrel there to the door of the wet bath. We're not sure what it was for. Here's the wet bath, and I wish that there was a small faucet and sink in there. We did add a new shower curtain and a little thing for the bottom of it. We took the standard shower head and replaced it with an Oxgenics for better water pressure and water saving. So these cubbies look plentiful, but they're actually pretty small. We added some artwork, basically some wall art. And each of the cabinets have dedicated shelves. The crock pot, bakeware, toiletries, linens, items for our three dogs are on this one side. And then on the other side, we have bed linens and our dishware. And then at the center, we each have one of these mesh drawers, and we use them to pack and unpack. We can take them into the house and bring them back and put them there. So makes great. It's a really easy system. These little hooks are from Cost Plus, and they're really cute. We use them for keys and dog leads. Here's another example of the wall art that we have. And then this above cabinet is all the standard stuff. The TV, the DVD, the radio, and the clock are all standard. And right here you have the flatware drawer, which doesn't close properly. Here's a look at the original decor. I really disliked that backsplash. So here's a look at what it became and how we remodeled it. And here's how we did it. We first tried this because it was a YouTube video that said this is how you do it, and it didn't work. It was starting to pull the wallpaper, actual back of it off. And so my husband did this, and it worked. I tried tin, which I really liked, but it was really sharp and it wouldn't stick to the wall. It was really frustrating. So we ended up with this, which I think looks really great. And here's a look at everything. Previous owner had this heavy-duty bar there. I'm not sure why. And he also had a lot of mirrors. So I replaced a lot of the mirrors with, for example, this is one of the things I replaced. Here's the over-the-sink cabinet and a look inside. There are some condiments and some coffee and tea, paper plates for lazy days. Under the sink, but because of that bar in the center, you can't really fit like a dishwashing bin, so you have to have things to organize. Under in this little cabinet, we have plastic bags and then measuring cups and measuring spoons. And then we took a bamboo cutting tray and a bamboo serving tray and used those as covers for the sink and the range. And so there's a look at it with the new backsplash. I think it looks great. And again, you've got the standard equipment. Behind that DVD and the clock, there's storage, but you can't access it. This large storage area next to the clock is great for things you need easy access to. And in the closet here, this is the only substantive closet. We pulled out the rod for hanging clothes because we don't use those. And we added a puck light because it was really dark. Here's what it looked like originally. It was the Harmony White, and that is a jackknife bunk bed up on top. It's pretty snug there, and a small person would be more comfortable. So we devised a new dinette and bed system because that table that came with it was just huge and really made the caravan seem tiny. So my husband came up with this idea of slats, and so here's some of our experimenting with these wood slats. And it added a seat, and here's when we first tried it out. And then this is what he came up with. So it was a slat and webbing system where you can use it for an extra seat, so there's like a U kind of area for the dinette, and then you pull it out and you can turn it into the bed. And that's what it looks like. And so you can see the changes. So for the table, he added this base, and then the poles. And then we have two different tables. The first one is a darker bamboo. It is also a cutting board. It is from Thailand, and it has this beautiful engraving in it, if you can see. It's quite pretty. And that's a nice little table for tea or appetizers or even just to pull out your laptop and look. And we store it in that closet, which is the only really spacious storage there. The second table, Jim found the tabletop at Habitat for Humanity for $2.98, and then we covered it with oilcloth from F&S Fabrics. And it looks really pretty. So we have those two tables. Again, here's a look at the previous decor. You can see the valances and the curtains. We removed the valances from the two sides, and then I fashioned these curtains. Jim reupholstered that middle valance, and this is all fabric from thrift stores. And so it cost about $4.98, the material. So it was great. Then I was inspired by this little chandelier decal, and I started to look for it, but then what I ended up getting was something totally different. It was from Amazon, and it was a set of these hanging lamps, and I think they look great. So I've got them up on the bottom of the bunk and then under the reading lights. So all the bulbs have been replaced. They're all LED now, and those lamps, those reading lamps, Jim replaced, which I think look great. So that's it. Those are our mods. It's an ongoing process. Here we are on Pacific Coast Highway. We tow with a 2004 Nissan truck. We're looking for perhaps something with a better towing capacity. But here it is on the road. And it works out pretty well. That's Doc Weiler. That's one of our three dogs, Brickle. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. And again, check down below and click on the link for what this caravan looked like originally. Thanks.